Hi everybody, it's Kevin from Going Batty. We're continuing on with our RV rebuild, remodel, renovation, whatever you want to call it. And we're just going to give you a few updates of what we've completed.
So what Jack is doing right now is he's sanding these walls right here.
Yeah.
So that way when we go to paint it, the paint will stick onto it and it won't just run off. Max, what are you doing?
I'm making the base for a vanity.
Cool.
Yep. That's pretty awesome. Not to worry
So this beast is gonna have to come out today.
So one of the things that my friend helped me do is he helped me pull out our furnace and get that taken out. We're not gonna have a furnace in this camper. We're gonna find other means of heat. And so we're gonna turn this into a storage bin, which we desperately need. And that's what we're gonna use that for.
So we're making progress, even though sometimes it doesn't feel like we're making progress. Today's one of those days where a lot of hidden things got done. So we're working on the bathroom and I bought paneling for the bathroom. Then right here, if you can see right over my shoulder here, that's the water heater underneath there. And I had a buddy come and look at it and he says it's working fine. We just need to re-plumb it because there's some holes in some of the plumbing back there, which caused all the water damage that's on the flooring back in the bathroom. So we got that solved and I know exactly how to fix that. We're gonna use some shark bites to keep those things together. So we rebuilt this corner over here. I rebuilt this corner over here with 2x2s and a little bit of 2x4 action. It looks a little wonky, but it is strong and it's not gonna go anywhere. We have some repairs to make to the sheet metal on the outside to draw it back in. But then we added these 2x4s over here for strength of the window and so we can build a shelf that comes out a little bit. Over here in the corner, restructured that. Rebuilt all of that and we'll just put paneling over that. And of course the shelf will come out and it'll come down here. If you look down here, there's some wiring we got to deal with and hide again. But right here's where the city water comes in. That'll go straight into the water pump. And then from the water pump, it goes out to the rest of the, camper. Right here, we're going to put a box where the water pump goes into. So if the water pump springs a leak or one of the seals springs a leak or something bad happens to it, it's contained in that box and it'll only flow in the box versus out all over the floor. Then we're going to put the water tank back here where this is, the shop vac. And so the water tank will go right back in here and we'll build the bed over that. And it'll come out to about where this line is right here. So we've got some work ahead of us still, and then we'll put paneling up here where it needs to be. So we've still got some work ahead of us, but we're much further than we were. So this is the water heater. And if you look at this kind of aquarium looking group of hoses, you can tell where some of the water problems have been. If you go down to right here, There's a hole right there where it leaked. And that's where we had the problems with all the water leaking. So this is this blue line going in is cold. Let's see here. That's cold, that's hot. Cold, hot. I'm not sure where that line right here goes, but it seems to go back underneath. Oh, that's propane. That's what feeds it. So that's the line that does the propane. I'm learning as I go, folks. Hang in there. We'll get it together. So cold. This is the propane line. That's cold. That goes out to the toilet right there. Okay. And it also goes out to the kitchen sink all the way around. And then over here, that line right there, if you can see at the tip of my finger, it goes around the corner. That's hot. See, I'm learning all this stuff, and
I'm really blessed because I wanted to learn this stuff, so it's exciting. All right, let's see if we can get this all fixed now. Good luck.
So with every project, there's one thing that you kind of put off because you know it's going to be just a bear. And this is one of the things that I'm going to be putting off. Let me show you. In this ceiling right here. We're going to take all that off. We're going to have to repaint it. We're going to have to do a lot of things because it's all crumbly. When you come up here and you touch it and press on it, there was a water leak around here. I don't know if there still is, which we're going to uncover. But that's one thing I'm just putting off right now because I know when we open that up, we're going to see a lot of dry rot. So anyway, wish me luck.
Very challenging project is not the box my children are trying to make outside this window, which, by the way, has been really fun to watch them figure out. But is this window right here. This window is broken and cracked all the way through here. And I have to replace this. And if you get close to the metal, you can see I don't have the first clue how to get that out. I think you take out this sealant right here, peel that out, and the glass will come out. So that's going to be a big chore when we do it. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to find some plexiglass to replace that with and see if it'll fit in this and just try to reuse that sealant right there because I think it'll come out. See the gap right here? It looks like it peels out. So I can replace that glass when I'm ready to. But that's another one of those projects like the ceiling I'm putting off.
I think all of you know how I've felt about this backyard. It has not had any grass in it. And this winter got even worse. So what we did is I planted some seed that's supposed to be specifically for being in the sun. And then we spread some straw and hay over it to kind of protect it from the birds. And we're gonna see how it does and how it grows. So we'll give you an update in future videos about how our lawn is growing. And we did it all the way back around the corner.
So I don't know if we talked to you about this or not, but Heather's starting to plant things and she's planting cold weather crops so that if they freeze, it's they're protected. But we're not expecting to get any more freezing weather here in Wyoming. Although I've heard rumors that it can happen. So we're optimistic that we're not going to get any more cold weather. Wanted to show you a little bit about what's going on right here. These are the two garden boxes that she built and Max built, actually. And she's planted some stuff in there and it's looking really good. She covered it with hay to keep the moisture in. And then we did the same thing back here with the grass where we planted some seed and then covered it with the straw. Hey, whatever. So we'll see how this works. I'm not sure. But look at the chickadees. They're like, oh man, I want some of that. So I threw a little bit of hay in there for them as a treat because they'll eat anything. I don't know if you know this about chickens, but chickens will eat anything. So we, along with the trailer, we've got some yard projects and some gardening projects going on. It's been a busy season here at the Going Batty Funhouse. I don't know if you can see it or not, but look at the color on this bird. It's a black bird, but when the sun hits it, it's green. How cool is that? And then, of course, you got your bird rocks. Very friendly birds. Golden lace Wyandottes. Golden lace Wyandottes. Araucanas. Easter eggers, sorry. Easter eggers. And then Buff Orpingtons. She's really come along. She was kind of the runt of the litter. Now she's holding her own pretty good, laying some great eggs. All right, ladies, we'll talk to you later. What? Hydrating going on right here. Blueberries, frozen blueberries. They take a little extra time, but they look pretty awesome. We're gonna go over here and try one. All right, the dehydrated blueberry. Chewy. Very chewy. Go ahead. So Heather's got these blueberries. She's putting them in this Ziploc bag. This is probably the cheapest option for sucking the air out of a Ziploc bag. There's a lot of expensive, vacuum sealers?
Yeah.
And this is one of the cheapest options, and it seems to work, doesn't it, Milo?
Yeah, it does. I think, though, that I'm going to there's a little rat, like, screen kind of thing that you can put in this that you can do, like, fruit roll-ups on.
Oh.
And I think I might get that, because the blueberries tend to fall through. Like, they fell through right here on this.
Oh, is that it? Oh.
So if you see there on there, that's where all the blueberries, like, fell through.
That's dead blueberries.
Yeah. We're going to see if we can...
This is a little difficult, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a little difficult.
It's a little hard to get it off the tray.
Yeah.
We like our new dehydrator, but it's not always this, like, straight up, this is how you do it kind of thing.
I mean, apples worked well in it. Bananas worked well in it. The blueberries did well in it. I need something that makes it easier to get them off. But we live and we learn.
As you guys know, not everything is useless. I mean, we reuse a lot of stuff. Some stuff we probably could reuse that we don't. But Heather uses the twine from our hay bales for her garden. So watch. All right. So what we've got plants. We got plants here. What are the plants, Heather?
These are pea plants.
And they're just going to grow up the stepping post, right?
Yeah, they need something to grow up. So I'm using the baling twine to give them something to climb.
A structure to grow up, huh?
Yeah, and I've done this before with like cucumbers and...
It works pretty good.
Yeah, I forget what else I did with.
Pretty awesome.
Trying to cute beans. I did it with beans too.
Yeah. So this is Heather's strawberry plants. We're trying them on hanging. We've never done it this way before, have we, dear?
No.
It's kind of cool though.
Look. If it doesn't work, I'm going to have Max build me some beds and we'll put a screen because the birds are getting in. My ears.
The birds aren't the only ones. That's really good. They're small, but they're juicy. It's a good strawberry. Mm-hmm. Feed them to our chickens, too.
No.
Here's another one. That's really good. All right, so this is the hot box. Point to us what's growing and what's not.
This is spinach here.
So spinach is doing good.
This is the arugula. Right here was the red lettuce. It's not done anything, and it didn't do anything in the tray that I have sitting up on the table either.
Do you think that strip went bad or whatever?
It might have. I mean, as good of an idea as seed tape sounds, it works with the arugula, but I mean, maybe I just need to plant like a row of seeds and, you know, because maybe the germination rate is just not as good with those.
So sometimes we have to try new products because everything else that we usually use is sold out.
Yes.
And this is a great example of it. Let me show you what Heather's doing. So Heather had to go to the store and get something different.
Yes. I wanted the little, like, I don't know, 1x1 square pots that you can reuse every single year. They're completely sold out of them. That's one of the drawbacks to being a small town where you only have really kind of one or two places you can go to get those kind of things. Everyone else had the same idea I did. So I settled for this here, which has it's got little starter pods in it. And you're going to wet them. You're going to put the vitamin pouch in with a gallon of water, wet these down, let them soak up the water, and then you're going to plant your seeds in the little holes. So we're going to give this a try and see how it does. See what else is in here.
He's never short on seeds, folks.
I'm not. But here is the bane of my existence. I can start just about every plant, almost every plant. But the one thing that I struggle with is I struggle with herbs. Like starting, I can never get rosemary to start. I can do cilantro and I can do oregano.
Didn't we have rosemary at Pershing though?
Yes, but I bought the plants.
Oh, I see. Gotcha.
So that might be one that I buy. So I'm just kind of looking through here and seeing.
So the seed goes in there?
Yes. So it goes in the little hole?
In the hole.
Yeah.
And then you cover it with the soil then?
No, you're not supposed to. It just kind of sinks down in there and it expands around it, I guess.
Wow.
So cool. We'll just see how it goes.
It's a little greenhouse.
It's a little greenhouse.
Is this going under your lights downstairs or staying out here?
It goes under the lights downstairs. Now this one didn't. I thought they all had covers. Oh, there it is. Never mind. Found it.
I hid it from her.
Let me see what else I have here that I need to grow. Cucumbers, cabbages.
All right, so what are we putting in here?
This is the vitamin.
Miracle Grow
packet, I guess.
No, it's not a Miracle Grow. It's something else.
It smells like it. Oh,
you
a
can
like,
smell it.
Like Miracle Grow.
You can smell it.
So we're gonna just get these.
See
soaked.
How this works. We'll give you an update on future videos as to how this works.
Yep.
They're floaty.
Yeah, we're gonna let them.
Saturated.
This one's starting to, you can see these are starting to expand already.
Oh, cool.
So hopefully, fingers crossed that these will.
Well, it didn't take long.
No, it didn't.
It didn't take long at all. Those expand quick.
Yeah. So, you know, they're still not.
Still not fully watered?
Yes, yeah, so there's still parts of them that are dry, so we're going to keep adding. I didn't want to overwater them because I didn't want them to be soaking, but this stuff expands really quickly, so. We're gonna, especially these corner ones seem to be, expand quite as much.
Yeah, this one looks like it's not.
Yeah.
You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of those dinosaurs you used to take in the bathtub with you.
Yeah.
They start out real small and then all of a sudden, poof.
Yeah.
You have a real live dinosaur in the tub with you.
I'm going to finish up the plantings that I started yesterday. I started some cucumbers and some tomatoes yesterday. And I did most of my canning tomatoes yesterday, like my San Marzano tomatoes. And I'm going to do my slicing tomatoes, my beefsteak tomatoes, and my cherry tomatoes today. So the instructions said to just make sure that the top, the little mesh on the top was kind of pulled away, and you just stick your seeds down in there. I'm doing about three, so that way, you know, well, maybe four. If one of them doesn't germinate, then some of the others might. So that's gonna be the beefsteak.
Ooh, look how organized.
I know. And I decided to cover the seeds up with a little dirt. Like I loosened the pots a little bit just because I was afraid when I was watering, the seeds would all just kind of
wash out.
So, but yeah, this is all we got going here. So I got, what's there? Those are bell peppers, jalapenos, cayenne pepper, basil, beefsteak tomatoes, cherry tomatoes, Hungarian wax peppers.
Basil's the one thing that you've grown before.
I have.
That you've done
I can
okay
get
on.
Basil and dill is the other one. So, and then the Ozark, giant red peppers, okra, zucchini, butternut squash, the Market More cucumbers, and spaghetti squash.
We always have huge zucchini plants.
Yes.
All right. These are cool little systems. Now they'll go downstairs under the light.
Yep.
Cool. Katie? What kind of plants are those?
Herbs.
Heather, walk us through it.
We've got, this is Italian flat leaf parsley. This is thyme. This is sage. I have some oregano in here, right here. And then that's rosemary.
And why did we go and buy a bunch of
a bunch of those because I have a hard time. Those are the ones I have a hard time starting. They don't want to grow for me and they follow me home. So, you know, what was I supposed to say?
She just can't help herself, folks. She loves to grow things.
Even when they don't want to grow sometimes.
Just remind people what they do to the, what you do to the bottom before you put them in the ground.
I listen up because you can see it's starting to look a little root bound. That means the roots are all kind of tangled around each other. And you just want to loosen those up a little bit right, so that they'll grow out into the pot. And then this guy with our rosemary, we're actually going to move it to the back porch where it gets more sun. And I'm going to save these because I like planting in those. Where it gets a little more sun and a little more heat because rosemary likes that heat.
Uh-huh.
So, and hopefully it'll come back next year because usually it doesn't in climates like ours because they're so cold in the wintertime. And the thyme has a tendency to want to spread out so I can have the taller in the back and the more spread out in the front. Gina, what are you doing? I'm staring.
That plant looked at her funny.
Oh, it's a bee.
Oh, it's a bee. Okay.
Don't eat that. You know how those affect you. Gina's pretty, but not smart sometimes.
She's not smart.
Do not eat that bee. Now I'm going to put my parsley and my oregano together. I'm growing out too. Getting old.
Okay.
Here they go.
So now you have resources so you can do whatever you're going to do. Doesn't this mean you plant more? Because you've got more pots now?
It's a sickness.
I know.
I'll plant plants and not have room to plant them anywhere, so.
So there's some pronghorn. So, we've had a pretty eventful weekend. We've had a lot of different projects this weekend, haven't we?
Yep.
We've had everything from working on the trailer to planting grass, to planting vegetables, all kinds of different stuff.
Yep.
And so we figured what we would do is we would end it with a few shots of the beautiful land, the beautiful state that we live in, Wyoming. And so we're going to end this by saying thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Feel free to comment down below and check out this beautiful scenery. See you guys in the next video.
Oh, sorry. It got bumpy.